Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to discuss about different types of firearm on the basis of four main characteristics. That is on the basis of the bore, on the basis of handling, on the basis of the loading mechanism, and on the basis of action. So before starting this video, guys, it's a request to you all to please subscribe to my channel and like this video and share it with your friends as much as you can. So let's get started. First is the classification on the basis of the bore. What is bore? Bore is the inner portion of the barrel of the firearm. So on the basis of bore, now the bore can either be rifled or it can be smooth. So on the basis of bore, firearm can also be either rifled or it can be a smooth firearm. Other than this, the mixture of both of these, rifled and smooth, is called paradox firearm. So let's discuss them. A rifled barrel has lands and grooves. So look here in this picture, you can see that this elevated portion is called land and this depressed area is called the groove. So rifle is going to have lands and grooves that causes the projectile to spin when it exits the muzzle end of the barrel. So these in rifled firearms, we get to see lands and grooves that is going to give a spin to the projectile. On the other hand, if we talk about a smooth bore, then it is exactly how it sounds. It is smooth. So there are no lands and no grooves in the smooth bore firearms. A smooth bore has no lands and grooves. And the example of smooth bore can be a shotgun. Alright. An example of rifled barrels can be rifle, pistol, revolver, etc. Now that there is no lands and grooves in smooth bore, so there's going to be no spin like effect, there's going to be no rifling effect. Now if we talk about the paradox gun, then paradox gun is like a shotgun with partially rifled barrel. Now some of the area, for example, is going to be, for example, if you look at this one, like this much area will be, you know, rifled, and the rest is going to be smooth. So a paradox gun is a shotgun with partially rifled barrel. That is, this portion is going to have the lands and the grooves, whereas the other portion left out is not having any lands and grooves. Then next comes on the basis of handling. How is the firearm held? So it can be either handheld, which is known as handgun, or it can be a shoulder gun, which is shoulder held. Alright, so see in this picture, this one is shoulder held, this one is shoulder held, and this one is hand held. So the projectile whose barrel is like very large in size, as like in this one and in this one, it cannot be hand held, it has to be shoulder held. And the one that are small, like for example, all these are having a very small barrel, so these are handheld. So a shoulder weapon is a firearm that is fired while held in the hands and braced upon the shoulder. So you can see here that it is braced upon the shoulder and it is held by the hands, so that is a shoulder weapon. But a handheld is a short barrel firearm. Look, the barrel is so small in all of these pistols and revolvers that you can see here. The barrel is like very small, that can be held with one hand only. So it can be held with one hand. The two most common handguns that are used are the revolvers and the semi-automatic pistols. Other than this, other are also there, like for example the machine pistols and the derringers. Derringers are also a kind of pistol only. Then on the basis of loading mechanism, we can divide the firearm into breech loading, muzzle loading, and magazine loading. So before that, you need to understand what is a breech end, what is a muzzle end. So this portion out here is the muzzle end, because this region itself is known as muzzle only. So this is the muzzle end. Whereas if we talk about this region, all these are breech ends. All right. So if the projectile is loaded out from here, from the muzzle end, then that is called muzzle loading firearm. And if it is loaded from here, then that is called breech loading firearm. And if it is loaded from here with the help of magazine, then that is magazine loaded. So A breech loader is a firearm in which the user loads the ammunition or the cartridge via the rear or the breech end here, as opposed to the muzzle loader in which loads the ammunition via the front area, like that is from here. So I hope you understood this. Then on the basis of action, now the action the firearms are of two type. It can be either manually loaded, or it can be automatically loaded. So on the basis of that, actions are also going to be different. Manually loaded firearms are going to have lever action, pump action and bolt action, whereas automatically loaded firearms are going to have action which is gas operation, recoil operation, blowback and blow forward. Now all these have been discussed in very detail in one of my video called The Firing Mechanism. I have provided the link in the description box. Do go and watch that video if you want to know about all these different kinds of actions in the firearms. This is a very important topic, so you must go and have a look at that video. I've provided the link in the description box. So this was all about this video. I hope you understood what are the different kinds of firearms on the basis of all the different categories. Thank you for watching this video. If you found the content to be useful, then please share it with your friends also so that they can also be helped. Also, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, hit that bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you.